Good morning. Pardon my filthy ass truck.
Where am I? New Mexico. Had a dirt lot.
Almost, well, actually I'm in Arizona. Pardon for the shaky cam. I am in somewhere right here, Arizona. Just a little bit away from New Mexico. Try to do 600 plus miles today. But before that, let's go up here. Everything's just kind of a mess. But there's my coffee. There's my Vasili beans. I got all different kinds of coffee. And here next, I'm going to show you my morning routine. Hopefully the microphone works on this like they say it does. I'm going to show you my morning routine before I can get going. We're at 5,500 feet, not as high as I've been, but it still takes a little bit of time to get going, and coffee helps. Before I get started, I'm going to do this. She sleeps up on the upper deck with me. If I leave her down here, she'll sit there and whine. She's up there, right there. So, hopefully the stabilization on this is as good as they say. First, and my cabinets are a mess. This my coffee bong. All right, hang on a second. There's me getting watching some Kimmel. Put that over here. And back there is the white. The white thing is what I can't use because it's a hot water pot. Plug it in, click it on, in 2 or 3 minutes it's boiling water. Pull it off, pour it into there. And then I can make coffee. But since I have no APU, I have no power inverter, I bought this briefcase. Yeah, there's my batteries. My batteries to my drone and my Nikon or my Canon camera that I can't charge, so put that up here for now. So hopefully I opened up on the right side. Hey, I did. There's that. There's a little gas can. It's probably getting close to being done. Push that down. Go up here. Crack my windows. My switch doesn't work over there for this side, so I gotta come over here. Crack my windows so I don't, you know, die in my pursuit of coffee. Alright. This routine has, I have to have my coffee, but it has sucked for cleanliness or tidiness. Alright. There's my coffee thingy, thingamajigger. It's my $12 gooseneck kettle. Up here, these are my coffee filters. I don't know if I can do this while I hold my camera. Hold the edge, because it doesn't like to go open up if you don't fold it. Fold the bottom. Make it round. Sit this over here for a second. Set the lid down. Get an extra filter out because I do this twice. All right. Now, thing I forgot to do before I sat down is, there's my messy floor, there's my bills of lading, my clipboard, my e-log. I take it off the dash at night so nobody sees it. Trash can, which also doubles as my thermos and my coffee cup holder. Trash bag, water storage. This isn't my official review of Vasily coffee because I can't use my grinder. So this is just my Javalier, and it's also, where is it, decaf. And there we go. Alright, now we go to this. Decaf. I never thought I would like it. I didn't like it before. But sorry about that. I never liked decaf before. But when I went home and had to go twice to get my medical card, because my blood pressure was through the roof, because I didn't eat before I went. Didn't have any, well, I had my nicotine gum, and I had coffee. At least one. Here, let me show you. When I say a cup of coffee, this is what I mean. So the second time I went, I went for a week and just had decaf. I thought this is going to be brutal because I like caffeine. But actually, made this way, it's fantastic. You really can't tell, and it's kind of placebo, I think, because I can't tell the difference, and I feel better anyway. Anyway, three. Three of those I found for me makes whatever coffee I make smooth, and I've never said this about coffee before, but creamy. I mean, it just doesn't have any of the bitterness. I'm gonna set this aside for now. And there's that. Kind of leveled it out a little bit. And I don't remember what the hell I was going to say. Anyway, this is my morning routine. Now, while the water's boiling, I go through and find videos that I might be interested in. There's Make Sense, Dale Jr.'s interviews, Potato Jet, guides on how-to stuff, Dale Earnhardt, which I'm not sure why, I guess because it's suggesting that because I'm watching Dale Earnhardt. There's Expediter Boogie, Less Junk, More Journey, Van Life, RV Life. They live full-time in their RV. I don't know why Conan's in there, because I don't watch that much. Super Trucker Dan, Nightly News, those have been popping up. Oh, hey, look, that dude. So I don't know what I'm going to watch. Maybe I'll start out with Make Sense. I'll watch some Make Sense. Can't really see it that close. Alright, we got this. This is starting to get hot. I can hear it. You can kind of see the steam. I'll give it just a little bit more. Get down here in my fridge. I was in Yuma and Phoenix yesterday. Yeah, close to sea level, closer to sea level. Now I'm at 5,500 feet, and everything that's bottled up is all expanded. So I go ahead and prepare my cups. This is heavy whipping cream. It is. Grams of fat per serving. So 1 tablespoon is 5 grams of fat. Fat is good. Fat is what you want. So that one's ready. Let's go ahead and get this ready. People do the butter and whatever. I didn't like the flavor of the butter in the coffee, so I don't do it. I like with heavy whipping cream though. I can't wait to go home this weekend. I'm going to Kansas City. When I get empty, I'm going to my car and I'm driving home. Couldn't find a load to the house. My truck needs worked on anyway, so I'll drop it off at the yard, let them come get it while I'm on vacation. And there's that. And then I'm on vacation, then I will hopefully get my truck stuff fixed while I go home on this coming what day? Oh, here, let me show you. I'm not gonna expand it because it has the barcode, but there, let me turn it around so I can see if it works. There it says. That blue, January 28th, 7:30 p.m., 2 tickets to see Metallica. That's my son's birthday present from December, and it'll be his first concert And since he loves guitar, he's gonna love it. And I went when 1993, and so I'm gonna love it too.
I believe it's hot enough. You can see the steam coming off. Let that cool down just a tiny bit. Go ahead. Let's go ahead and move Mr. Make Sense. And I'm gonna kind of stand up so I can see this. The handle's still a little hot. Try to get all that wet. Nice and saturated, and you can kind of see it bubbling. That's the carbon dioxide. I think they call that letting it bloom. You're breaking down, letting the ground break down. So the next time you pour, they're broken down and you'll get a better brew. No bitterness, less bitterness. As you get over a coffee maker, regular coffee maker. I'm just talking out my ass, because all I know is I've watched a bunch of YouTube videos, and I still don't know how to do it. I just know how to do it that makes it good, that makes it good for me. I like it.
Now you see it's all getting nice and foamy and bubbly, and in the center, going around the edges, the center should kind of foam up a little bit more, carbon dioxide releasing all the bitterness. At least that's my understanding of it.
Hurry up. Damn, it is slower than just a regular old Mr. coffee maker or whatever. But as last week, me and another one of our drivers ran all the way from Washington to Denver together. I made reference to him in my What Do You Want video. I was like, hey, I get to show somebody, let's get somebody else's opinion. And so every morning he got up and sat in the driver's seat, because my passenger floor packed with water. So not only do I drink a lot of coffee, I drink a lot of water during the day. Alright, so there's that. It is done. Stir it up a little bit. Yeah, I drink coffee with a straw. Sorry. Hurts my... I hate coffee burning my lips. It's not ideal for the coffee connoisseur. It will judge my ass off. It will judge me to death. But I don't care. That's the way I like it. Mixture of oxygen and coffee. I get that. I just don't like burning my damn lips and my roof of my mouth. This gone by the time the next pod's made. So I have this, half of that, make another one of these, and the other half into that. And the second one of these is for the road. This one's just to wake up. So anyway, I went to Starbucks to have them show me how a professional does their coffee. Yeah, it's got to be better than their brewed coffee. You know, the regular, however the hell they do it. No, it wasn't. It may have been a one-off. I may be better at a Starbucks in Seattle, but it wasn't good in Tennessee. And she's like, I don't know. I put this much in,
this is how much they tell me to put in, and just pour over. She did none of the blooming thing. And granted, she said, I was trained a little bit several years ago when I started. So Starbucks gets the people that don't love coffee think Starbucks is fancy coffee. It's not. It's not. It's burnt. It has a burnt taste, and they do have a dark roast bean, most of it. But even that, I bought a bag at Walmart of the medium roast, or it may have been dark roast. I can't remember. Took it home and I made it like this. Night and day difference. Tastes fantastic. So if you want Starbucks, make it yourself. It tastes really good. That's my morning. Thanks for watching. Click subscribe somewhere down here. Click the like button or the dislike button if you dislike coffee. I don't care. On that little subscribe thingy, hit the little bell so you're notified when I make something. I'm going to try to make more videos this year. Be more diligent. It might not be perfect videos like I psyched myself into, but I'm going to make more videos.